Chapter 2, Summarizing and Graphing Data. 2.1, Frequency Distributions for Organizing and Summarizing Data. The key concept, when working with large data sets, a frequency distribution or frequency table is often helpful in organizing and summarizing data. A frequency distribution helps us to understand the nature of the distribution of a data set. A frequency distribution or frequency table shows how data are partitioned among several categories or classes by listing the categories along with the number, which we call the frequency, of data values in each of them. Lower class limits are the smallest numbers that can belong to each of the different classes. Upper class limits are the largest numbers that can belong to each of the different classes. In the example shown, we have four classes. They're listed horizontally here for illustrative purposes. The lower class limit, the smaller numbers that belong to each class, are 75, 125, 175, and 225, as listed here. The other ones, the upper class limits, are the numbers that are in the class that are the largest numbers. So 124, 174, 224, 274, and are listed here. Class midpoints are the values in the middle of the classes. Each class midpoint can be found by adding the lower class limit to the upper class limit and dividing the sum by 2. The class width is the difference between two consecutive lower class limits in a frequency distribution. This is the same example of classes that we just used in the previous definitions. And to find the class midpoints, we simply find the sum of the lower and upper class limits in one class and divide by 2. If I look at the very first class, the lower class limit is 75, added to the upper class limit of 124, and then divide that sum by 2, I find the class midpoint to be 99.5. To find the next class midpoint, I would follow the same procedure. I would add 125 and 174 and then divide by 2, and I would get the class midpoint for the second class of 149.5. Same procedure for the other two classes. The class width is the difference between two consecutive lower class limits. So to find the class width, I would find the difference between 75 and 125. And that difference is 50. I could find the difference between 125 and 175, or I could find the difference between 175 and 225, since those are all adjacent lower class limits. And you'll notice that the difference is still 50 for each one of those groups. So the class width is 50. Class boundaries are the values that split the difference between the end of one class and the beginning of the next class. Again, we're using the same four classes that we had in the previous slides. And this time we're looking for class boundaries. Class boundaries are found by adding adjacent classes, one upper class limit with the lower class limit, and dividing by 2. So we're basically looking for halfway between the upper class limit of one class and the lower class limit of the adjacent class. To find that halfway between mark, we simply add those two values together, 124 and 125, and we divide that sum by 2. The class boundary then is 124.5. And we continue in the same manner, adding the lower class limit and the upper class limit of adjacent classes, dividing by 2 to find this halfway mark to find the class boundaries for each of the classes. Now, notice that for the last one and for the first one, I don't have the other number to find the midway point. So what I do is I use the class width. The class width was 50, and if you notice, each of these differences is 50. So to find this number, this last class boundary, I simply add 50 to the preceding class boundary. And in order to find the first class boundary, I would just basically subtract 50 from 124 to find the number that would give me the difference between the two numbers of 50. So that's how you find class boundaries. So let's do an example. The example is blood platelet count of males. We have a frequency distribution, which is here. So the blood count is for each class listed. So the first class is 0 to 99, then 100 to 199, 200 to 299, etc. And the number of males with a blood platelet count between 0 and 99 inclusive is 1, between 100 and 199 inclusive is 51, and so on to get the frequencies. What I'd like to do is to have you identify the requested information for the given frequency distribution: the lower class limits, upper class limits, class width, the midpoints, and the boundaries. So the lower class limits are the first numbers or the lowest numbers within each one of these classes, which would be the ones that I'm circling. So 0 is the first lower class limit. Then 100, 200, 300, 400, and 500. The upper class limits are the class limits that have the higher value, and in this particular case they're circled in green. So those would be 99, 199, 299, 399, and so on. The class width, remember, is the difference between two lower class limits of adjacent classes. So 100 minus 0 is 100. Notice that that's also the difference between adjacent lower class limits and upper class limits. So from one class to the next class, the difference between those limits is the class width of 100. Class midpoints can be determined by adding the upper and lower class limits in a class and dividing by 2. If I use my calculator, add 0 and 99, and divide by 2, I find my first class midpoint to be 49.5. 49.5. Continuing in that same pattern, add the upper and lower class limits of the second class and divide by 2. The second class midpoint is 149.5. What do you notice about the difference between the first class midpoint and the second? It's the class width. I can then use that information to find the remaining class midpoints, simply by adding the class width to each of the preceding class midpoints to get that class's class midpoint. And then the class boundaries, just like we did in the previous example, the class boundaries are the halfway marks between the end of one class and the beginning of another. So the end of this class, the beginning of that class, would be 99 and 100 halfway between, which is 99.5. Now I've left a little space here because I want to include the number that's in front of that 0 lower class limit for the first class, and we'll do that in a minute. The next boundary would be between 199 and 200, which is 199.5. And notice that the difference between these is the class width. So I can find the remaining class boundaries simply by adding the class width to the preceding class boundary. Now the 599.5 would be my class boundary here. So to get this first number, I simply take the 99.5 and subtract the class width. So 99.5 minus the class width of 100 is going to give me negative 0.5. And that's going to be my first class boundary.